Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Indiana Hoosiers and the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Here are two players who will need to help carry the load for their teams today. And there is the starting lineup for each team.
The matchup in the post should be a great one, Gus. Two imposing figures out there and attract a lot of defensive attention.
Here's a look at how these teams plan on controlling the tempo. So here we go.
They come out in a minute.
They work the perimeter. Shots up. No.
Push it.
Ivy receives the pass. The Hoosiers set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Meeks handles the feed. Jump shot.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Lynch receives the ball. Fired. He missed it.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
On the outside. And we'll get a change of possession. They work it around the perimeter. Lobs it inside. York handles the pass.
How about that elevation?
Thanks for joining us here on CBS Sports. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery. Top of the key. He shoots from the right of the circle. He can't get it to go. Jump shot. And hits. Fired. And he can't get the bounce. He got it up and in. On the wing. Jump shot.
Got it!
Meeks is certainly making his presence felt there.
He's a banger, Gus. Uses that bulk and size to score in the 3-second lane.
In the paint.
Bang!
On the left side. Up and in. Ha-ha! How about him taking it to the cup, Bill?
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
In the post. Fires. Off the mark. What a rebound. Dump it inside. He looks for three. Comes up empty from deep. And he lays it up and in. They work it around the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. On the outside. In the lane. with the answer. The Hoosiers did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got the ball to the big guy at the high post, and the D just couldn't react in time, Gus. That's often the case when the ball goes into that area of the court.
Low block. He strokes it.
How about that, Gus?
Loose ball batted in. York turns it over. They work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. Shots off.
What, a coach will be happy with that effort.
On the left side. No.
Get out and fill.
Out on the left wing. In the lane. He missed it. Grabs the rebound. On the baseline. In the lane. He can't get it to go. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Turnover committed by the senior. Down on the low block. Fires, and he can't get the bounce. Top of the key. In the lane. And in. Great job of occupying the high post. I think that's why they were able to get that basket.
They got the ball into the most precious area on the court. You're right, Gus. The high post is an area it's just so hard to defend.
On the outside. Jump shot. The senior. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a bit easier.
And what's great about this kid is his ability to find the open man and also put up some points.
He rejects it. Now on the run.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Off the mark.
Dominating the glass.
On the low block. Jump shot. No. Pulls it in. They work the perimeter. Shot rejected. Out on the wing. Fires. He missed it. It's a call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Being a freshman can be intimidating, but the key is to find out different ways to contribute to the team. It doesn't always have to be scoring. If he can do the little things and play strong defense, he'll be helping out his team.
Hits that. May be in some trouble. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender under control.
Tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Gus.
Dump it inside. Jump shot. He can't get it to go. What a rebound. In the post. Fires. Shots off. Pulls down the rebound. Out on the right wing. can finish. This guy is a complete player in the post.
Gus, he's definitely what I call a complete post-up player. He can do so many different things and really demand your attention on the defensive end. Just an outstanding talent and prospect.
Shots off.
And he looks to outlet.
Out on the left wing. Jump shot. The freshman. Around 8 minutes remaining. Top of the key. Turnover by the senior. Nice low post play. Good entry down into the box. Fires. I'm not sure if he called that one, but it's good nonetheless. Receives the pass in the paint.
And lays it in.
Bill, they're running their offense through the high post.
Doing a great job running your offense. Working it through the high post, that's what they need to do.
Down on the low block. You just can't be that aggressive.
And get away with it.
Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Well, Bill, this young man's now in his second season of eligibility.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
The traps in place, Rath. Long lead pass.
Put a little English on it.
In the post.
Inside.
Out on the left wing. 6 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. Jump shot. Shots off. Takes the rebound. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside. The junior. Way out on the right wing. Fires. And he can't get the bounce. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. Off the mark.
See the floor. You can get some easy fast breaks.
We're at the 5 minute mark. Looking for a good shot. And it's blocked. Got it in the low block. Fires. Shots off. Snatches the rebound. lobs it. They work the perimeter. Got it up and in. We're at the 4 minute mark. They work it around the perimeter. 5 on the play. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus. Gus, as a coach, your seniors are really, really important. The other classmen will look to them for guidance and direction. And when a senior is accepting of this role, it really helps out the coaching staff and the team as a whole.
They've got him right where they want him. In the post. Jump shot.
Big time dagger.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Fires. No.
Rebound and run.
Three minutes left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. Heat check time from long range. Coach calls a timeout. Back with more in a moment. The Hoosiers lead as we go into the timeout. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball action after this. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Hoosiers working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Careless mistake there. The Golden Gophers in a hurry. On the outside. He missed it.
What a rebound. I own it.
The Hoosiers now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Shots off.
Great strength.
We are at the 2 minute mark. Out on the right wing. In the lane. He can't get it to go.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arms.
In the paint. And that's a jam. knocked away. Great block. Loose ball saves it. Great play. And he gets it. Didn't seem as though anything was going to stop him on that take, Coach.
Gus, that's a great take. Drive into ecstasy. He drove with conviction and was rewarded with the hoop.
We are at the one-minute mark. In the post. Up and in. Ha ha! In the post. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. They work it around the perimeter. Turnover, they'll go the other way. On the inside. And he lays it up and in. Cut back door and receive the pass.
Boy, well-timed backdoor cuts. They're just pretty to watch, Gus. Not to mention the finish.
Dump it inside. With a big shot. Shots off. One half is in the book. Stay tuned for CBS at the half. And a look at our game summary will give you an idea of how these two teams are stacking up against one another so far. Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game.
Gus, how about a little... Wait a minute!
Now they work it around the perimeter. Stolen away! Looking for a good shot. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. The Hoosiers set up four around one.
Just tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
Way out on the right wing. In the lane.
It's good.
They work the perimeter. Off the mark.
Look to outlet.
Feed the low post. In the lane.
Got it. Wow.
They work it around the perimeter.
Buckets.
The Hoosiers have controlled the tempo here.
Gotta love the way they've come out here and really focused on their game plan. They've done a good job making sure the game is being played at their pace.
Can't get it to go. The fans are making a difference, Raph. This is a tough place to play. No.
Great inside control.
Out on the left wing. Jump shot. Shots off.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
They work it around the perimeter. Fires and answers. Creighton has a terrific handle, and he can get to the rim. I mean, talk about a slasher, right?
Really puts the pressure on the D, Gus. Really nice off the bounce, and just takes it strong to the 10.
With 10 to shoot now. Can finish. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that. Wouldn't you agree, Coach?
Wow, Gus, when you drive it with authority, only good things happen. Drives like that usually end up with a basket and or a foul.
On the wing. Dials up a long-range shot. No luck from downtown. Nice low post play. Good entry down into the box.
How about this kid, huh?
On the outside. Now with the ball screen.
He missed it. When you get an offensive rebound and then score, it really is disheartening for the D.
There's the pick. Entry pass in the paint. He can't get it to go. Takes the board. On the right side. Shots up. Can't connect from the three-point line. And lays it in. And there's a careless pass that's stolen away. Now looking to attack. Foul on the play. Too aggressive on defense here. And he winds up with the foul.
He always gets your hand reaching in and getting in trouble.
With the pair. He misses it. Gotta make the freebies, Billy. He manages to keep it in. Dump it inside. Alley-oop. And we have a change of possession here. The Golden Gophers have come out here and are really focused on moving the ball and playing pretty together.
If you're on the floor, that means your coach believes that you can make a contribution. This team has received quality play from many different individuals.
The Hoosiers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
On the right side.
Put a little English on it.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Turns it over. Out on the left wing. Looking for the bomb. Your bear is the three-pointer. The Golden Gophers, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
The freshman.
In the post. Jump shot.
He got it.
In the lane. He drains the shot. In the post. He swats it away. They work it around the perimeter. In the lane. Shots off. Rips down the board. They work the perimeter.
Inside.
On the wing. Fires. Answer. Lobs it inside. On the right side. Heat check time from long range. And no! It's stolen away. Here they go in transition.
Ah, he got it up and in.
Out on the wing. He attempts the three.
How about that?
Out on the right wing. In the lane. The sophomore.
Young man showing off his mid-range game.
Out on the left wing. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock.
Perfect.
A great finish on that backdoor feed.
Oh, what an explosive cut to the tin and just a terrific feed. What a finish, Gus.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Second team foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Couple of free ones.
Chance to breathe.
It's good. Makes it. May have him right where they want him, Raph. On the right side. We've got a backcourt violation.
Well, you don't want those type of violations to add up.
It's important that you get bench players who can contribute.
Well, it seems like everywhere you look, somebody's contributed a basket or two. They're really playing together, and that means everyone has a chance to get a good, clean look at the tin.
On the wing. He shoots from the corner. With no luck, snatches it down. Top of the key. Shots off. Great offensive rebound. Up and in. Ha ha! We are at the 7 minute mark. And while we have a moment, let's take another look at our star matchup.
At this point, the important question is if their team is winning. If so, nobody's worried about the stats.
Baseline inbound. And he on the left side. Dials up a long-range shot, but he misses his target. Dump it inside. Off the mark. Cleans the glass. Got it in the low block. 6 minutes left on the game clock. No. Ivy gives them another chance. And he lays it up and in. Receives the pass in the paint. And the ball is out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, Gus. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
The Hoosiers running their zone offense.
Now, this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
They work it around the perimeter. From the corner!
How about that, Gus?
Bill, they're running their offense through the high post.
Doing a great job running your offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Jump shot. He missed it. Hungry for the ball. The Hoosiers motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
We're at the 5 minute mark. Meeks handles the feed.
Look at that block. Terrific reaction.
Do they need a timeout here, Ray?
Gus, they definitely need a timeout. They've lost their composure.
We've got a timeout. More CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA right after this. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. In the paint.
Big time dagger.
Marshall receives the pass. Fires. He gets that one to fall. Travis handles the feed. Jump shot. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. York receives the ball. We're at the 4 minute mark. In the post, in the lane.
How about this kid, huh?
Work it around the perimeter.
Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy.
The Hoosiers are doing a terrific job of controlling the game.
Really done a great job establishing a good pace. A pace that suits their strengths as a team.
Call for the foul. How about a second time? Check out this layup.
How about the concentration at the 10? The spike being banged in the paint.
handles the pass. They're called for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just gotta know when to back off.
A chance for two.
Great attack. Gets it.
Both free throws go. Steals the ball. No!
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
On the left side. It won't fall. He takes it away. Way out on the right wing. Can finish. They've worked the perimeter.
And he bangs it down.
We are at the 2-minute mark. Looking for a good shot. And lays it in. On the wing. Jump shot. And he can't hit the shot. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They've just got to be completed.
Down in the low block.
How about that? Huh?
Under 1 minute remaining on the game clock. He can't get it to go. On the left side. In the lane. The shot won't fall. Big finish coming here, Raph, and we're staying put.
Offensively, this is when the star players should have the ball, Gus. It's time for the playmakers to step up and lead their team to victory. Now they really have to foul in order to stop the clock, Gus.
Baseline inbound.
English on it.
We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. On the left side.
Great defense.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not? Some people dread this part of the game, Gus, when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Foul. And that stops the clock again. And that's it for him. That was his last personal foul, and now he's fouled out. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
Gets it. Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Rath. Length of the floor. Fire! He drains the bucket. Foul. And that stops the clock again. To the line. Makes the shot. No, not this time. On the left side. He throws it up from downtown. And he misses the shot. Ivy gets the pass. And here's a look at our players of the game.
Ah, some great performances here, Gus. These two were special and really stood out.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for now. Tune in for more college basketball action on CBS Sports, brought to you by EA Sports. For Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson.